One example where SDN can provide huge wins is in the data center. A data center typically consists of many racks of servers, and any particular cluster might have as many as 20,000 servers. Assuming that each one of these servers can run about 200 virtual machines, that's 400,000 virtual machines in a cluster. A significant problem is provisioning or migrating these virtual machines in response to varying traffic loads. SDN solves this problem by programming the switch state from a central database. So supposing I have two virtual machines within the data center that need to communicate with one another. The forwarding state in the switches in the data center ensures that traffic is forwarded correctly. If we need to provision additional virtual machines or migrate a virtual machine from one server to another in the data center, the state in these switches must be updated. Updating the state in this fashion is much easier to do from a central controller or a central database. Facilitating this type of virtual machine migration in a data center is one of the early killer apps of software-defined networking. This type of migration is also made easier by the fact that the servers are addressed with layer 2 addressing, and the entire data center looks like a flat layer 2 topology. What this means is that a server can be migrated from one portion of the data center to another without requiring the virtual machine to obtain new addresses. All that needs to happen for forwarding to work is the state of these switches needs to be updated. The task of updating switch state in this fashion is very easy to do when the control and data planes are separate.